Ladies and gentlemen, as I've always said, atheism is a big, fat scam. It's really a Trojan horse for Marxism, socialism, even communism. And here, Jimmy and Matt, I'm going to show you how they're wrong, wrong, wrong. They're trying to rationalize why Kamala Harris lost the election. Okay? And you can go watch them cry in their soup on this video right here at the bottom about the resistance begins now. I mean, that is so lame. The resistance. These two guys that couldn't even help Kamala Harris get voted in, they're the resistance. Well, Democrat Party. Here's your stormtroopers, Jimmy and Matt, the resistance. Here's what's so funny. It's so funny to watch these atheists melt down as their darling Marxist candidate, Kamala Harris, loses the election. But you know what? Atheists deny reality, so they're not going to stop here. They're not going to say what every single person believes, that Kamala Harris was a horrible candidate. She sucks. Everyone knows that. She's a horrible candidate. She hasn't accomplished anything worthy to talk about. She was a horrible candidate. Even when she ran as president, she just did horrible. She's a DEI vice president. More proof and evidence that DEI is a failure. But let's go through this. Listen to what Jimmy says as he cries in his soup because his darling candidate lost. And listen to the reason why he says that Kamala Harris lost. He's not going to say what the reason really is, that she was a sucky candidate. Just be honest. She was a horrible candidate. She makes Dukakis look like a genius. She was a sucky candidate. Just face reality, you guys. But no, you know what they're going to say? They're going to say that the majority of the American people, because Trump got the popular vote, they're all wrong. But Jimmy and Matt, they're the resistance. They're the correct ones. Right. Listen to the madness of the Democrat Party.
I had posted, I can't tell you the amount of 2016 vibes I'm getting from all these. She is definitely going to win replies and posts. I posted that 5 days ago. And you have this person who wrote, in 2016, women didn't have to worry about losing the right to control their own bodies. Guess what?
Wait, wait, wait. The baby's not their body. This is wrong, number one, that Jimmy says. The baby's not their body. It's going to grow up if you don't murder it, and it'll be a separate body. It's not the woman's arm. It's not the woman's lips or nose. It's going to be a separate human. But watch this. Listen what Jimmy says. This part, he's going to say the right thing, but then he's going, well, let's let him say it.
Trump won women. And in fact, this is one of the moments, one of the times where we have to look at things and realize we need to disillusion ourselves, not with only our opposition, but our own side. And one of the things that got sent, one of the things that is hard to say, and listen, we're definitely going to have a black person on at some point to talk about this because hearing it from my white face isn't going to make you feel any better. Or, you know, I'm not necessarily the one to give a lecture on it, but our group had this idea, the left has this idea that if a person comes from an oppressed minority, they won't have other bigotries. And
Did you get that? The bigots, all those people that voted are bigots, according to Jimmy. This is the resistance. Look, with resistance like this, the Republican Party has nothing to worry about. You just heard him. They're bigots. Let's continue. All the American people, the popular vote, they're all bigots, but Jimmy and Matt, they're the good, holy people.
the thing that we found out, that people had actually warned us of before, including, I can remember one conversation I had on this channel, is that do not count on black men to vote for a black woman.
Now, he just basically said that black men are racist against black women. The problem, Jimmy, you really should think before you speak. Wasn't Kamala Harris the vice president? So let me get this straight. The black men don't have a problem with black Congress women or black senators, just black presidents. This is what Jimmy's saying. Jimmy, did you forget that she's a black woman? She's Kamala Harris. She says she's black. She's already in power. Doesn't Jimmy pay attention? Look at all the black women that have been in politics. I can't believe he would mess up. But then again, Matt and Jimmy are wrong, wrong, wrong. So first he says, you know, you heard about how he's saying there are people, all the people voting are bigots. And the black men now, they're racist against black women. This is what he really wants to convince people of. Just say the truth, Jimmy. Kamala sucked as a candidate. It's very simple to say. I'm willing to admit that Mitt Romney sucked as a candidate. But just because someone has a D in front of their name, no, you guys, you're going to do what you're good at. You're going to deny reality, and you're going to say Kamala Harris lost because the black men are prejudiced against black women. Let's continue with the stupidity.
Do not count on queer people to vote for a woman.
So now the queers. Oh my gosh, Jimmy. Jimmy really is trying to sell you on the fact that queers don't want to vote for women either. The queers, this is comedy gold. This is the resistance. The queers are now against black women. But wait a minute. There's all types of black women in power, in political office. What's Jimmy talking about? Well, let's listen to the resistance speak some more.
Do not count on women to vote for women. Because
so now women. This is madness. These atheists are delusional. So women now don't vote for women. Let's rewind this because let's let it play all the way through this time because I don't want to cut them off. This is madness. Just say that Kamala Harris was a sucky candidate. She was. She's a horrible candidate. Just say the truth. But no, the resistance, they're going to deny reality and say this.
For example, I had posted, I can't tell you the amount of 2016 vibes I'm getting from all these. She is definitely going to win replies and posts. I posted that 5 days ago. And you have this person who wrote, in 2016, women didn't have to worry about losing the right to control their own bodies. Guess what? Trump won women. And in fact, this is one of the moments, one of the times where we have to look at things and realize we need to disillusion ourselves, not with only our opposition, but our own side. And one of the things that got sent, one of the things that is hard to say, and listen, we're definitely going to have a black person on at some point to talk about this because
It
from my white face isn't going to make you feel any better. Or, you know, I'm not necessarily the one to give a lecture on it, but
that's weird, huh? Like if something's truthful, who cares whose face it comes from? But this is the typical Marxist ideology where you divide and you label and you categorize people into different categories. But let's let the resistance speak some more, shall we? This is the resistance. These are the guys that are going to single-handedly, you know, turn this country back to Kamala Harris-ville.
But our group had this idea, the left has this idea, that if a person comes from an oppressed minority, they won't have other bigotries. And the thing that we found out that people had actually warned us of before, including, I can remember one conversation I had on this channel, is that do not count on black men to vote for a black woman.
Now, think of what Jimmy's saying. The black men, he's saying, are bigots. That's what he's saying. They have bigotries. Every black man that I know that has voted for Trump has reasons that they lay out. They like his policies. They like that he's not a race baiter like the Democrat Party is. I never hear a black man even expressing or hinting that they don't like black women. They'll tell me how they love their moms. The mom's black. Their family's black. But see, these black men, they're Christian black men. They're not racist. And thank God for the strong Christian black men that put the nail in the coffin of the Democrat Party. I mean, you guys got destroyed. And get used to it. It's going to keep happening. But you're the resistance, so let's see what your plans are.
Do not count on queer people to vote for a woman. Do not count on women to vote for women, because patriarchy seeps into, and by the way, those are tough things to hear, again, coming from my mouth. I am willing to blame white supremacy and patriarchy for all of those.
Wow. So let's get this straight, Jimmy. Let's get this straight. White supremacy caused the queers to not vote for Kamala Harris. This is retarded. This is a tough sell, Jimmy. But then again, you're atheist. You believe that life came from non-life. And if you'll believe that, you could believe anything. Jimmy believes that the black men, somehow white supremacy convinced these black men not to vote for Kamala Harris. And the queers, don't forget, white supremacy convinced the queers not to vote for Kamala Harris. Oh, and then the women, Jimmy's even saying the women were convinced. You know, he's saying it's white supremacy's fault. Really, you guys? This is why you lost the election. This is madness. You guys should be ashamed of yourself. This is like something 15-year-old idiots do. This is not intelligent. This is not reason. This is not rational. But then again, you guys are atheists. You believe life came from non-life. Let's continue and let's hear what the resistance says.
Because they seep into every one of those communities. And one of the darkest fucking things we have, worse in America than other countries, is that our form of patriarchy has successfully convinced women to specifically, a lot of women, not every woman watching, certainly, a lot of women to find the idea of another woman succeeding as awful. There is a huge, everybody watch.
This is just ridiculous. This is just ridiculous. Now he's saying women don't want women to succeed. This is what atheism does to your brain, folks. This is mental retardation. Go listen to these guys. They're like the Beavis and Butthead of the resistance. Now let's continue. Listen what Matt says.
When Hillary Clinton called them a basket of deplorables, she was right. Now, that doesn't mean that we're assessing the character of every Trump supporter, because I guarantee you there are Trump supporters out there that don't realize how much they've been duped. They don't realize how much misinformation they have. They don't even realize the consequences of their action will be the harm that they pretend doesn't exist. But there are plenty of others who know exactly what they're electing. Both people who are hooray, this is my guy, I want the Christian nationalism thing. Anybody can be elected.
Wait a minute. Let's rewind that.
When Hillary Clinton called them a basket of deplorables, she was right.
Wow.
Now, that doesn't mean that we're assessing the character of every Trump supporter, because I guarantee you there are Trump supporters out there that don't realize how much they've been duped. They don't realize how much misinformation they have. They don't even realize the consequences of their action will be the harm that they pretend doesn't exist.
What harm is there? let me guess, he's against Christian nationalism. You know, these atheists are promoting secular nationalism. The Christians have the right to promote what they want. The Muslims have the right to promote what they want. Everyone has the right to promote what they want. And may the best man win.
But there are plenty of others who know exactly what they're electing. Both people who are hooray, this is my guy, I want the Christian nationalism thing.
There it is.
And the people who are, yeah, anybody can be elected. I don't want another politician. I don't want a lawyer in office. I want a businessman, a failed businessman who's filed for bankruptcy like 6 times and managed to bankrupt a casino and who, you know, nobody would consider to be a good businessman based on his actual track record.
Really, Matt? Matt's a big fat liar. Let's take a look at how much Donald Trump is worth, shall we, ladies and gentlemen? I think that the guy on the right that is part of this new atheist resistance is a little bit jealous. Matt, do you have a calculator? Forbes has assessed that Donald Trump's wealth is $5.5 billion, more than you and I will ever earn in our lifetime. Why are you lying to people saying he's a failed businessman? But this is the madness of atheism. Let's get back to the resistance. This is the madness of atheism. They deny reality. It's people like Jimmy and Matt that got Donald Trump elected. You guys helped elect Donald Trump. It's what you're saying, what other Democrats say, and it's not true. Just quit lying to people. I just pointed out you're lying. We just showed you how Donald Trump, how much he's worth. I mean, what do you want it to be, $6 billion? Then he's a success. I mean, please. Let's continue. Okay, so we already proved that the guy on the right lied. And Matt, you're wrong. Now, listen to the madness that the other guy that's part of the resistance says. Listen what Jimmy says here.
Are saying, I actually did vote for him. I'm sorry, and they are especially responding to when a person will make a post of going, just so you know, if you voted for Trump, that means you voted to harm me and I don't feel safe around you now.
That's crazy.
Our friendship is not unaffected by you voting against my human rights, by my civil rights, and then them getting messages back of like, oh, well, this is just a ridiculous, politics is a ridiculous thing to get upset about and cut people off about, when just ask them to define what politics is. Human rights are a part of politics and human rights are worthy of a boundary. And yesterday, as I put it on Threads, we had a lot of things on the ballot, including, just to put as ineloquently as possible, rape was on the ballot. And yesterday, rape won.
This is just a lie. I am aware of everything that's on the ballots all across the United States. There's nowhere where it says if you want rape on the ballot, Proposition R or whatever. This is just a lie. Rape wasn't on the ballot. But this is what the atheists do. Have you noticed that atheist and Jimmy and Matt, they're the queens and kings of this. They love to do this. They won't say abortion. They'll say reproductive rights. Because if you say abortion, everyone knows you're basically murdering a child. So, ladies and gentlemen, Jimmy's sad that Mamala didn't win. Matt's sad that his Mamala didn't win. I am so happy. Let freedom ring. Well, I'd like to tell Jimmy and Matt, good luck with your resistance movement. Yeah, I'm sure you guys are going to get real far with that.